what actually the dipole is. That is the particular charges having a magnitude minus q plus q, and they are separated by a distance, finite distance. We call it as a dipole. Suppose this is the center of the dipole, and let us consider P is the point which is at a distance of r from the center of the dipole, where we want to calculate the electric potential . I think this point is clear to all of you, or any confusion? So the value of the potential at point P, because of the charge which is at point A, what are the two things are required? Number one, amount of the charge. Number second, the position. So how we calculate minus q? So kq upon r, how we use the formula? This is kq upon r, so it becomes minus kq upon r plus a. Is it clear why it is r plus a?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because it is at the center, so it is divided into two parts. So this is equation number one. Similarly, we calculate v2. We have given the name v2. This is equal to kq upon r minus a. This total distance is r, and we subtract this particular gap, so we are getting r minus a. So in order to calculate the potential, because potential is a scalar quantity,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, please repeat how the equation 1 and 2 come.
By using this formula, V is equal to kq upon r. Due to this charge, which is at point A, this is the magnitude of the charge. Is it clear? Minus q, is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
And this point is at a distance of r plus a from point P, where we want to calculate the electric potential. Is it clear or not? This r plus
yes,
a
sir.
Is clear or not? Is it clear, beta?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Similarly, we have written equation 2 because it is at a distance of r minus a. So we are getting equation 1 and 2. So in order to calculate the total electric potential at axial point of a dipole, what we will do? We add 1 and 2. We get kq minus 1 upon r plus a plus 1 upon r minus a. Taking the LCM, it becomes a plus v and a minus v. This is equal to a square minus v square. So that is why r square minus a square. So here it becomes minus r plus a, it becomes r plus a, r and r cancel. So it becomes 2a. So ultimately we get kq 2a upon r square minus a square. And we know that this is the definition of electric dipole moment. That is P is equal to Q into 2A. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So it becomes KP upon R square minus A square. So this is the final result, that is electric potential at axial point of a dipole. So this is kp upon r square minus a square.
सर यहाँ पे एक को नेगलेक्ट नहीं करेंगे।
If required, then otherwise we not disturb this equation. Okay. In some cases, if it is required, otherwise we will use this formula directly. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Come to the next point. That is calculation of electric potential at equatorial point of a dipole. Equatorial, the point is clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
At this particular point, which is at a distance of r, this is a dipole, this is plus charge, this is minus charge. As it is a scalar quantity, so there is no importance of the attraction or the repulsion. And how we calculate the potential at point P because of these charges? We have given the name here. This point is A, this point is B, this point is P. So potential at point P because of the point charge which is at point A, that is minus kq upon under root r square plus a square. Is it clear or any doubt? We have to write down the formula v is equal to kq upon r. So what is r here? This is r square plus a square under root. Is it clear? So that is why,
yes,
this factor comes into play. I request everyone to respond with me. If any doubt, you ask, no problem. So this is r square plus a square. So similarly, for the second case, only the magnitude, that is only the sign of the charge changes, rest of the terms remain same. No. To calculate the total potential at point P, V is equal to V1 plus V2. And when we add these two values, so they will cancel out each other. And we are getting V equatorial is equal to 0. That is, at equatorial point, equatorial point of a dipole, the electric potential is zero. Is it clear? Calculation of electric potential at equatorial point of a dipole, is it clear to all of you?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us continue one of the problem. This is a numerical problem. I have appeared in the board examination also. The 2 point charges minus Q and plus Q means dipole are located at 0, 0, -a and 0, 0, +a. Calculate the electric potential. Just a wait. We have to first locate the charges. we have to locate the charges. So obviously this is a coordinate system and charges are located on the z axis. Are you getting this or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So what we have to do? We have to, first of all, we try to locate the charges. Just see how we are locating. Suppose this is Y, this is Z, and this is X axis. So A is located in the minus Z axis. So this is 0, 0, you can mention if required minus A, no problem. This is point A where minus Q charge is located. This is point V where 0, 0 A charge is located plus Q. So are you able to explain the concept? The potential to calculate the electric potential due to this dipole. How we go through this now depends upon where the point of observation is. Are you getting my point? If the point of observation or the point where we want to calculate the electric potential are on the z-axis, so it becomes a axial cases. And if it is on this particular axis, are you getting my point?
Yes,
what
sir.
Is the yes, what sir. Is the value of the electric potential at 0, comma whatever you can write down, for example Y? What is the value of the potential?
No.
Are you getting how the conceptual part comes into play?
Zero.
Is it clear? Because it becomes a dipole in this way, and here is the point of observation.